this weekend, the high school football season gets underway. We're talking today to Walton football coach Jim Hoover. Coach, a big big early season schedule coming up. I know you open up with some Class B schools. What about this week's opener, Chenango Valley?
Well, Ron, we lost a lot of people last year, so there's a lot of question marks. We only have a couple offensive starters back from last year, and we have, three defensive starters. So there's a lot of question marks out there as far as what we can do. There's a lot of talent there. There's a lot of good people there, but what they do under pressure, it's going to be tough to tell until we see, after the first game or two.
Awful hard to tell this early in the season. What's your handle on the team? How have they looked so far?
Well, they've been working hard. We've been out there since August 15th. The kids are really a pleasure to coach. Boy, they're there every day. They're both, for the first practice and the second practice, they listen, they do what they're supposed to do, and they're easy to coach. They're a good group.
Have you been in a situation like this before where you had so many starters you had to replace?
I think so. I think over the years we've always had a senior-dominated ball club, and it's going to be that way this year. We're young, but we're young as far as experience goes. We're not really young as far as age goes. We're going to have a lot of seniors starting this year. But as far as experience goes, we're a young football team, yes.
You talk about Chenango Valley. A B school, a large school on the road, a difficult opening ball game.
Well, according to the Binghamton Press the other day when it came out, they have a lot of starters back from last year's team, and the way they're talking dome already and playing on AstroTurf, and they're again a Class B school, so it's kind of scary going against them. But again, you never know this early in the season. This should be a real challenge for us.
What about the rest of the season? I know you're in Division 5. You don't get scheduled started with that division for a while. What about the rest of the preseason? Again, some very tough-looking football teams.
Well, we scrimmaged Norwich a couple of days ago also, and we looked pretty good against them. They're supposed to have a decent team. We did very well. We open up with four Class B schools in our schedule. If we had a veteran ball club, I would say it probably would be to our advantage because it would be good for us. But having a young team, I don't know. It's again, a lot of question marks out there. If we do well, it could be to our advantage. We could get our confidence up. But if we lose the first one or the first couple, it could hurt us as far as our confidence. So maybe it wouldn't be too good.
Coach, nice talking to you today. Best of luck this week against Chenango Valley and a tough schedule. Good luck.
Thanks a lot, Ron.
For the local sports, I'm Ron Golling.
The 1994 football season began for Walton at Chenango Valley. Watch quarterback Kevin Radiker fake to the first back and set up Akins on the Walton counter. 81 yards later, Walton scores. Jason Lauderette picks up 42 yards thanks to the work of right guard number 74 Rob Gould and number 79 right tackle Glendon Cooper. A quarterback sack, Tim Bartlett. Watch quarterback Kevin Radiker fake to the running backs, roll to his left, and find number 12 Mark Hall for 11 yards. On this play, on the pitch, number 31, Kirk Akins, stretches the defense and scores from 37 yards away. Final score, Walton 49, Chenango Valley 8. Week 2 of the season, Walton played a vastly improved Susquehanna Valley team for the Walton home opener. Walton Orange Crush defense made an early statement. Walton led early and broke the game wide open with this electrifying 76-yard punt return from Aaron Lauterette. Watch Jeff Lambert shooting in from his linebacker position to make this defensive stop. Number 44, Walton fullback Jason Lotterette takes on a would-be tackler, maintains balance, and continues for a big game. Watch number 56, left guard Gabe McLennan on the trap block. Teammate Kirk Akins turns it into first and goal. Final score, Walton 27, Susquehanna Valley nothing. Walton took on Seton Catholic as the season reached week number 3. Rob Gould puts pressure on the Seton quarterback, result, incomplete pass. The blocking of number 69, Andy Grossman, number 56, Gabe McLennan, and 57, Seth Reynolds, leads to a Walton touchdown. Gail Neal puts pressure on the Seton quarterback, and the Walton pass coverage is too good. Incomplete pass. This time, Aaron Lotterette reads the play and makes the tackle. Final score, Walton 38, Seton 18. The following week, Walton took on Eastridge, a Class B school from the Rochester area. The game was at Johnson City. We pick up the action with some vintage Walton cross blocking. The result, a Kirk Akins touchdown. On this play, watch the charge of the Walton defensive front. The Walton pop pass. The result, touchdown Walton. The defense comes up big again. This time, Gail Neal on the interception. Rob Gould takes the outside route to the quarterback for an orange crush sack. Keep an eye on quarterback Kevin Radiker as his series of fakes confuses the Eastridge defense, and his pass to Jason Lotterette results in another Walton score. Another big-time tackle from Rob Gould results in a loss of yardage for Eastridge. Final score, Walton 60, Eastridge 8. Week 5 for Walton, the opponent was Delhi. It was the first divisional game of the year, and the Bulldogs brought to town one of their best teams in years. At the bottom of the screen, keep an eye on number 57, Seth Reynolds, who not only turns in the Delhi ball carrier, but also makes the tackle. Glendon Cooper, right tackle, number 79, makes a big-time block, and Kirk Akins, a long run for Walton. Quarterback Kevin Radiker sidesteps a would-be tackle and finds Kirk Akins for a key touchdown against Delhi. Number 89, Tim Bartlett with a kick-out block that springs Kirk Akins for the winning touchdown. Final score, Walton 20, Delhi 13. After the Delhi win, it was back on the road for unbeaten Walton as they prepared for back-to-back Friday nighters at Oxford and Sydney. With the ball, Kirk Akins, number 31, behind solid blocking, picks up big yards on a power sweep. Kevin Radiker and Jeff Lambert make Oxford's defense recognize them, while Kirk Akins counters for a Walton touchdown. Quarterback Kevin Radiker, throwing accurately on the run, finds Neil Bartlett for a Walton first down. Again, quarterback Radiker to the air, this time a jump pass to tight end Tim Bartlett. Final score, Walton 28, Oxford nothing. At Keith Clark Park, Walton introduces Sydney to big-time defensive pressure. This time, Mark Hall with a good gain, set up by the cross-blocking of Rob Gould and Glendon Cooper. Sydney tries the ground game, but the crush defensive pressure is too good. Again, Walton defense featuring number 37, Aaron Lotterette. Kevin Radiker, with play action, finds number 81, Walt Jones, open for a big gain. Jeff Lambert powers across from in close and another Walton touchdown. More Walton pressure. The defense meets at the quarterback. Kevin Radiker reads the defense, takes off, and picks up a key first down. Final score, Walton 32, Sydney nothing. Walton returned home for the stretch run. To reach postseason, the Warriors needed to beat both Unitego and Windsor. We pick up the action with Unitego, number 57, Seth Reynolds, top of the screen, makes the tackle in the backfield. Jason Lauderette scores from in close for another Walton touchdown. Kirk Akins adds the conversion, concluding another successful Walton drive. The Walton defense comes up big again, led by Jeff Lambert and Rob Gould. More Orange Crush defense as they break down the play. Kevin Radiker rolling left. Kevin spots Walt Jones, who tightropes the side of the end zone and makes a great catch. Back to the ground on a punishing inside run by fullback Jason Lauderette, who keeps working until touchdown Walton. Final score, Walton 56, Unitego nothing. The season came down to a winner-take-all confrontation with Windsor. We pick up the action with a first-quarter sweep by Kirk Akins. On the dive, Akins gets close. Jason Lauderette scores. The Black Knights had a chance late in the first half, recovering a Walton fumble on the 3-yard line. Enjoy the goal line stand. Walton continued to lead 6-0, but Windsor threatened with a long, time-consuming drive. It was first and 10 at the Walton 15-yard line. Glendon Cooper jars the ball loose. Jason Lauderette recovers and runs 85 yards for the clinching score. Kirk Akins is on the receiving end of a Kevin Radiker pass for the Walton conversion. Walton defeated Windsor 14-0 to advance to the postseason. Walton finished the season with 4 straight shutouts, had a 9-0 record, and were ranked number 2 in New York State. Walton met Tioga in the Section 4 bowl game at Cornell. The Walton defense comes up big early with this crushing stop. Chuck O'Dell and Jeff Lambert team up on this defensive gem. Walton broke on top on their first play from scrimmage. Kirk Akins lines up at the bottom of the screen and is wide open for this Kevin Radiker pass and an 81-yard touchdown. On Walton linebackers Jason Lauderette and Jeff Lambert as they team up for a tackle. Again, good team defense for Walton as they string out and then stop the play for a loss. Glendon Cooper flushing the Tioga quarterback, and Gail Neal and Tim Bartlett combine for a sack. At the bottom of your screen, check out the collision at the 25-yard line as Jason Lauderette meets Jason Bellis of Tioga. Mark Hall with perfect technique on pass coverage defense. Kirk Akins on the Walton counter picks up good yardage. This time, it's Aaron Lauderette with the good gain. The key block supplied by number 31, Kirk Akins. From the 41-yard line of Tioga, Kirk Akins combines power, balance, and breakaway speed to score again for Walton. Tim Oles, Scotty Watford, and Glenn Cooper record a quarterback sack. Kevin Radiker again finds success through the air, this time to number 81, Walt Jones. Just prior to halftime, the Walton offense electrifies the crowd at Cornell as Kevin Radiker and Aaron Lauderette hook up on this 34-yard touchdown to give Walton the lead. the bread and butter of Walton's ground game, the counter. Akins for 18 yards and a first down. Jason Lauderette, behind great cross blocking, rips through the Tioga defense for a long run. This time, Kirk Akins works over the center of the Tioga defense. Kirk Akins again gets Walton close. Kevin Radiker finishes off the drive behind a huge surge from the line. Aaron Lauderette adds the conversion, and Walton extends the lead. First, stopping the Tioga ground game, then trapping the Tioga quarterback, Scotty Watford, and Gail Neal on the sack. A key play in this game, with Tioga driving late in the contest, Glendon Cooper with pressure forces the fumble, Tim Oles on the Walton recovery. Kirk Akins on a long run, and Walton makes plans for the Carrier Dome. Final score, Walton 28, Tioga 20. Walton versus Dalgeville, the number one and two teams in New York State, meeting in Syracuse for the regional championship. Dalgeville comes in with a 41-game winning streak, and Walton the winner of 10 straight. We join the action early on Walton's first possession from their own 42-yard line. Enjoy this Kirk Akins touchdown run. It's number 12, Mark Hall, on the conversion, and Walton leads 8-0. Kirk Akins again with a carry, as Walton ran well all afternoon. The Walton defense makes its presence felt on this gang tackle. On this play, hard-hitting Jason Lauderette forces a fumble. Again, the Walton defense shuts down the Dalgeville attack.
3-back set with Akins lining up in a squat. It's short. John, this is where they ran razzle-dazzle from before. They give the ball to Akins on the razzle-dazzle around the corner to the 30-yard line, up to the 33-yard line, and to the 35 and the 36 and a first down. Receivers to both sides. Aaron Lauderette comes back in motion to the short side of the field. Lauderette gets the ball on first down, picks up yardage to the 46-yard line, second down and a yard to go for Walton, near midfield.
On the next play, Walton fumbled a snap. Kevin Radiker recovered, and it was a Walton first down. Walton picked up 5 yards on a Radiker to Akins' completion. Walton was then whistled for illegal procedure, and when we return to the drive, it is second and 10.
The deep pitch comes to Aaron Lauderette. Lauderette to the 50-yard line, down to the 45, knock out of bounds at the 45. Will be third down and two. Walton has a chance, third down and two, from the 44-yard line of Dodgeville. On third and two, Radiker sets the offense. The handoff is a first down inside the 40-yard line. That'll stop the clock while he moves the chain. Again, Akins picks up the first down at the 39. Walton football from the 39-yard line of Gaza. Here comes the counter play to Aaron Lauderette. Cuts inside, down to the 35-yard line. There is one play left in the Walton season. On fourth down, Radiker can't find a receiver. He rolls out. His pass is complete. Down first to the 30-yard line for a first. Radiker calls signal. Radiker back to pass. Sets up, looks long, throws into the middle, open, touchdown Walton! As Will Jones has scored with a minute four left, he got behind the defense. Single setback as Aaron Lauderette gets the deep pitch. Lauderette running right side, scores! So now it's going to take a touchdown to beat Walton.
Final score from Syracuse, Walton 16, Dalgeville 12. With the dramatic win, Walton earned a trip to Rochester, their opponent, Falconer, in the state semifinals. The Walton defense started strong against Falconer, Mark Hall and Rob Gould on the stop. Tim Bartlett, with strong penetration, breaks down this play. Once again, it's Tim Bartlett, this time forcing and recovering the fumble for Walton. Again, no place to run for the Falconer back. But the aggressive Walton defense denies. Jason Lotterat makes it look easy as Walton draws first blood, 6-0 Warriors. The Walton special teams have been solid all season. Here, watch as the kickoff team shows great downfield coverage. Number 14, Chuck O'Dell, comes up big for the Walton defense. Kevin Radiker and Walt Jones again hook up for a Walton first down. The counter scissors became a big part of the Walton ground game against Falconer. On this play, Aaron Lotterat with a huge gain. The Walton sweep to Kirk Akins continues to gain ground. Your final score, Walton 20, Falconer 12. Aaron Lotterat was named Offensive Most Valuable Player. Jason Lotterat, Defensive Most Valuable Player. Walton earned the right to return to the Carrier Dome at Syracuse for the state championship with Hudson.
great disgrace, waving your banner all over the place.
Slow up, no, I don't take shit. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up.
I don't ever slow up, no, I don't take shit. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up and make a statement. I don't ever slow up, no, I don't take shit. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up and make a statement.
Everything I do, so instinctive and so passionate. Every word I move, so descriptive like an adjective. I got a vendetta against people who patented being negative when you should be getting after it. I got facts over tracks, isn't that spitting slow, spitting fast. I could roast, I could gas, think I'm okay at last. But I don't know if that can erase all the past. And the pettiness, a reflection of the emptiness. Hilarious, you think you're worth my time, you're delirious. Mysterious, because you hide behind a fake exterior. Inferior, you know I'll always be a bit superior. Get off of me, this ain't no humble brag. I want you to hear words, you can say them back. I want you to feel free from the chains at last. And to believe in what you got, it was built to last, yeah.
Now that I've been put through hell, I never got anyone's help. I had to do it all myself.
I don't ever slow up, no, I don't take shit. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up and make a statement. I don't ever slow up, no, I don't take shit. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up and make a statement.
I'm gonna learn the consequence of being incompetent. Mental health is confidence, dreams into modestness. I'm not here to save the day, that's for you to take away. I could play a million mind games, but instead of say something not illogical, something that is topical. Rub it on and watch it go, make yourself unstoppable. Dreams are irresponsible, but they're always possible. If you just believe, you could be so remarkable.
Thoughts in my head, a collage and they spread. I'll be great one day, going off of my meds. No, I'm not giving up, no, I'm not giving in. I will make it to the top, taking off in the wind. I gotta make it, I'm saving every day to taste it. I'm patient, but my mind, it can hardly take it. I'm chasing a dream that I've had for several ages. A vacant modern kingdom for the taking.
Now that I've been put through hell, I never got anyone's help. I had to do it all myself.
I don't ever slow up, no, I don't take shit. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up and make a statement. I don't ever slow up, no, I don't take shit. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this.
and everything that goes with it. I thank you all, but it's been no bed of roses, no pleasure cruise. I consider it a challenge before the whole human race, and I ain't gonna lose. It's got me. We are the champions, my friends. And we'll keep on fighting till the end.
We are the champions. We are the champions. Who's time to lose them? We are the champions.
All the world. We are the champions, my friend.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of New York State football, I thank you for attending this afternoon's championship football game.
We've seen a lot of signs in the last few weeks, like one of them that you'll remember was "Good Night, John Boy, Good Night, Walton." Well, ladies and gentlemen, tonight, Walton is alive and kicking with a New York State Class C champion. Hey, who's number one in New York State? Division champions, section champions, intersectional champions. Something about New York State champs, that just has a great ring to it. I just want to say something about the whole team, the program, the coaching staff, the players, the cheerleaders have done such a sensational job all year. And what about the crowd today? All those Walton fans, it looked like a Syracuse home game today. Says it's 8:15, folks. I think we've got all night to party.
I was going to tell Coach Ruhlman and his team how much Walton thinks of them. I know they know it now. You people have told them what they think. The greatest team in the state of New York.
You know, on the way home today on the bus, we were talking about last week's parade, and we said there's no way that the community could do any more for us than they did last week. And boy, I tell you, you did it. I don't know how.
All right. I'd just like to thank the whole community and everything for, like, everything they've done for us this year. That's tough, Bob. This isn't just coming from, like, all the adults that have been back in the olden days when they teach you respect and everything. This is coming from the team and the younger people. And I'd like to wish next year's team good luck and keep the streak alive.
Well, what can I say? We do it for Walton. Do it for Mr. Hoover, do it for ourselves, do it for the team. Brought home number one.
I'd just like to say one thing. I'd like to say give it up one time for the best fans in New York State.
Yes, I'd just like to say thanks to Coach Hoover and all the coaches. Mr. Jacobs, thanks for taping our ankles every week. Thank you very much.
On your behalf. Let's hear it for the cheerleaders, number one, for their work this year.
Football season, fantastic. Football players, coaches, cheerleaders, band. And we want to thank Mr. Burtmore for putting everything together. It's a great place to live.
Back on September 3rd, 48 teams in Section 4 began the season with one common goal, win a state championship. Almost 3 months and 240 games later, only Walton High School can say they are the best team in the state. Chris Matthews was in Syracuse for the game today against Hudson High, and he has this report.
It was a classic matchup of two teams looking for their first state titles in football. Walton flexing first, the Warriors strike on an 8-yard pass to Walt Jones.
Our running game did the rest. If we didn't run, there's no way we'd complete passes like that.
Walton didn't enjoy its lead very long. A few minutes later, Hudson comes right back. Leroy Collins from 14 yards out, 6-6 after one. Walton scored the only points of the second quarter. Kirk Akins on third and five goes in for the score, 12-6 at the half.
You kind of had a feeling it'd be a pretty tight ball game here at the Dome in Syracuse. These teams are so similar. They both run the ball. They both use the clock. And most importantly, they're both looking for their first state championship.
My, how things changed. Third quarter, Walton scores 16 unanswered points. Kirk Akins takes it in from 8 yards out. Then 3.5 minutes later, It's Jason LaTourette who gives the Orange Crush a 28-6 lead.
When you're ahead 28-6, you can kind of relax a little bit.
Really disappointed that we gave up that many points.
With a running back like Leroy Collins, you can't relax too much. He's a good running back.
When the outcome was no longer in doubt, Hudson's Leroy Collins still fun to watch. The state's rushing king had 199 yards on the ground, most in the second half.
I think I did good as I've been doing all year.
As the clock ticked down, Hudson's hole was just too deep, and Walton wins it 28-18.
All interviews after conducting.
Our offense just started clicking in the third quarter, and when our offense starts clicking, I don't know, it's just like a machine.
This is great. There's only one chance in a lifetime for a state title, and I got it my senior year in football. I couldn't ask for anything more.
Team stayed together really well. It's best team unity, and that's our key.
Our kids really deserve everything they got.
They're really well coached, and they deserve to be state champions. They're definitely the best team we've played all year.
Walton's first title and the first for Section 4. In Syracuse, Chris Matthews, Action Sports.
Chris, Kirk Akins was named Offensive Player of the Game. Jeff Lambrecht was named the best player on defense.
Congratulations and best wishes to Coach Hoover.
officially proclaimed the week of December 5th through the 11th, 1994, as Walton Warriors Football Week. Congratulations and best wishes to Coach Hoover, the Walton football team, and the staff, the cheerleaders, and the 1994 Walton Warriors football team. You don't know what you may have done to our board meeting, but for the next year, I know when we go to the meeting where there are other school districts represented, the first thing that will come up is Walton. Oh, you have the state championship football team. You're right, you do. So thank you, gentlemen, for bringing that honor to us.
Over the last few weeks, numerous people from throughout the state have contacted me to offer congratulations on the success of our football team, and invariably, along the way, congratulations become a comment about how classy our team was.
That is signed by every single student at Townsend School.
Strength to carry.